9th standard.
And I'm Mitch Kavya from 9th standard.
I'm SS Nimeta from 9th standard.
And this is the overall abstract of our proposed system. At present, farmers could not able to monitor the whole agricultural field, and also they cannot control the small pests. Using wireless technology, we can control the small pests even in long distance. The proposed system gives introduction of the idea of IoT technology, and our proposed system will give the idea of controlling the pest and also controlling the overspraying of pesticides in the field, which gives increases the field. Now my friend will give small introduction about our proposed system.
So in our proposed system, we have used an ever-growing network, that is IoT, Internet of Things. It is a communication between the physical object, which has the feature of an IP address, and other internet-enabled devices for the internet connectivity. Some benefits of IoT are machine-to-machine communication, automation, time, information, monitor, money. Automation of daily tasks leads to the better monitoring of devices, efficient and saves the time. So this ever-growing network is used in the agriculture. Normally, agriculture is a difficult task. In agriculture, pest control is the main task. So if we detect the pest at the early stage, we can reduce the yield loss from 20% to 40%. Nowadays, the farmers are walking in the field and they are monitoring and they are spraying the pesticide. For a change, instead of walking, we can use this IoT technology and they can monitor their field and they can spray the pesticide. This system will reduce the overspraying of pesticide and increase the soil fertility. These are the some other IoT technologies. We are using the drones for the field monitoring, water management, soil monitoring monitor by using the soil monitor sensor, and the machines for the routine operations and daily task. So there are many vegetables and fruits which are affecting by the pest, but we have taken cabbage for our research and how to identify and get rid of cutworms. Usually the cutworms cheat through the plant stem and get into the soil and it will cut the roots. So if they cut the roots, then the water supply will not be there for the plant growth and it will destroy the old plant. And cutworm is a name which is given to the group of larvae of the adult moth. Cutworms are caterpillars, but they are mistakenly considered as grubs. This is the architecture of our proposed system. This is the node MCU microcontroller which is used in our proposed system. We have to give the power supply to the board, and the sound sensor is connected with the microcontroller. Sound sensor here, it is used to detect the sound frequency of the pest, and temperature sensor is to detect the temperature in the farm, because the sound depends on the temperature. And this microcontroller is connected with the cloud, and cloud is also connected with the Blink mobile application. If the pest is detected, it automatically sprays the pesticides and the sirens alert. So there are many pests. We have taken the four problematic pests: cabbage looper, cutworms, diamondback moth, cross-tipped cabbage worm. So cabbage looper, which will eat the leaves of the cabbage and it will destroy the cabbage head. Then the cutworms, as I said in the previous slide, it will cheat through the plant stem and get into the soil, it cut the roots. Then diamondback moth, it is a problematic pest which will affect the growth of the cabbage in the early season. Same the cross-tipped cabbage worm. So to control these pests, we have to spray the insecticides in the high volume at high pressure. This will be the overspraying of pesticides. This system will control the overspraying of pesticides. So this slide will be explained by my friend.
In our system, we have used some of the sensors like JSN B02. It is a bioacoustic sensor which can measure up to 40 kHz sound frequency. And right now in our system, we have used the EC0177 sound sensor which can measure only up to 20 kHz. And LM35 is the temperature sensor we have used in our system, because the speed of the sound will vary in the temperature. And now my friend will explain about the components used in our system.
And this is the bioacoustic sensor which should be used in the real application to detect the pest. Certainly, cut bombs will produce a frequency up to 20 to 22 kilohertz. So this sensor can measure the frequency up to 40 kilohertz, and also has a certain features more than the sound detection sensor module, and like small size, and is also easy to use. It consumes less power than the sound detection sensor module, and it can be used in wet and harsh environment condition. It gives more high accuracy, and it has also certain specifications, such as the working voltage of this sensor will be 5 dB, and it can measure up to 40 kHz. But in our research, we have used sound detection sensor module which can measure up to 16 to 20 kHz. This sound level set point can be adjusted by the potentiometer, and this module has also a LED bulb which gets illuminated when the sound level set point can exceed and the output strength is very low. Its operating voltage is 3.3 volt and 5 volt. In our research purpose, as the bioacoustic sensor is very cost, we have used sound detection sensor module. In our research, we have passed the ultrasonic sound waves by the ultrasonic sensor, and it can be detected by the sound detection sensor module. We have used temperature sensor LM35. It is the basic experimental purpose temperature sensor. It gives reading in centigrade, and it can also measure the body temperature. The reason why we have used temperature sensor is the sound basically dependent on the temperature. That's if the temperature of the surroundings of pest varies, the sound produced by the pest also varies. If the temperature increases, the sound also increases. Whereas if the temperature decreases, the sound also decreases. So this sensor will help our proposed system to give the high accuracy. We have used microcontroller node MCU. Certainly there are more microcontrollers such as Arduino Uno and Arduino Nano. As we have used Blink software in our proposed system, we also need a Wi-Fi connection. And this node MCU has inbuilt Wi-Fi. Certainly Raspberry Pi or some of the microcontrollers in which the Wi-Fi is inbuilt. But to make our project simple, we have used node MCU. And it has certain programmable pins. And now I'm going to give an introduction about the node MCU which we use in our proposed system. And it is an open source IoT platform which can be used by common persons. It is a firmware which runs on the ESP8266 Wi-Fi system on chip. The hardware of ESP8266 is based on the ESP8-12 module. It has also certain specifications such as the sensors which we use. The memory is up to 128 kilobytes, and the storage which can store the value node MCU will be 4 megabytes, and the power supply to the node MCU will be USB. And my friend will explain about the Blink software which we use in our proposed system.
As there are many servers based on the IoT like ThingSpeak, PubNet, Microsoft Azure, ExoSight, Nimbits and Blink, in our system we have used the Blink server because it is very easy to use with the mobile application. As there are some sensors which are inbuilt in the mobile application, like proximity sensor, GPS module and accelerometer sensor, which will be used by this Blink application when we are using it. Blink is an open source server which makes the communication between the mobile phone and the Microsoft like microcontrollers like Arduino, Raspberry Pi and many more. We can use this Blink application easily only by the widgets like buttons, sliders, LCD display and gaze. With this Blink application, we can able to control the pest spraying pump automatically. This is the analysis of the sound frequency which we have recorded from the surroundings of the farm. The pest like cutworm creates up to 22 kHz sound frequency, but the sensors we have used in this system can detect only up to 20 kHz. So we have coded like when the frequency is in the 1000 Hz, we can detect it is the pest. And the pump will automatically spray the pesticides. This slide shows that Blink application we have used in this system will make us easily to monitor the frequency recorded from the sound sensors. And we can able to monitor the frequency level by the graphical representation. And the switches in this Blink application makes us easily to use. Next slide. And we have used the temperature sensor in this system because the speed of the sound may vary in the various temperature. When the sound frequency is 1000 Hz, its wavelength will be 0.3. And when the frequency is 1200 Hz, the wavelength will be 0.28. And the speed of sound will be 343 meter per second at both the cases, 20 degrees Celsius. The speed of sound in air will be 386 meter per second at 100 degrees Celsius. The speed of sound will be increasing 0.6 meter per second with each increase in the temperature. So we have used the temperature sensor in this system to monitor the sound frequency clearly. This is the flowchart of our proposed system. When we start the system, the sensors will start measuring the frequency and temperature. When the frequency is between 20 kHz to 22 kHz, it will start the information data counting. If the count is equal to 4, the relay will command the pump to spray the pesticides. And if the count is not equal to 4, and again the sensors start measuring the frequency and temperature, and the program will be end. This is the program which will be explained by my friend right now.
So this is the program which we done in our proposed system with the help of our trainers. And first few codes, these codes says that we had included many libraries.
You can skip this. You can explain overall essence. Okay. And skip it.
They are asking to explain overall, that's it.
Yes, essence of that, then you can skip to the next one.
Okay. Next.
So this is our proposed module and this is done in our research lab.
Click. Oh, next. Click. Sound. Conclusion. Next slide.
So we understood that you have done, right?
So this will be explained by method. Finally, we are concluding that with the help of our system, farmers can able to eat the large number of cabbages. Right now in our system, we have made the system to get rid of pests in the cabbage field. But we can research about all other food items and we can also make the pest control system for other foods. By this system, farmers can yield large quantities and we can also increase the fertility of the soil. It will diminish the weight of the agriculturists by avoiding them to manual observing of the field. With the help of this, farmers can lead a technological farming to get rid of pests. These are the papers and websites we have referred to know more about the sensors and servers we have used in this system. Thank you. At this moment, I would like to thank our staff members, Dinesh sir, Devraj sir and Suganti ma'am, and our school management who have motivated us in this research field. Thank you.
Thank you.